Hey there, Michael Church, Crawl Space Ninja, and recently we released a video about ERVs and HRVs, and I'm gonna put a link to that video down below, but is there ever a time when you may need something different to ventilate your home? Also, make sure you stay tuned to the end of the video because I'm gonna share with you what I feel is one of the very first things every homeowner should do to improve indoor air quality. Okay, so if you're new to Crawl Space Ninja, we talk about everything related to attics, basements, crawl spaces, and ductwork in relation to indoor air quality, energy efficiency, and comfort. So make sure you subscribe to our channel and ring that notifications bell. So if you're not familiar with whole home dehumidification, basically a whole home dehumidifier is when you take a dehumidifier and you duct it into your HVAC system. This way the ductwork of the heating and air system or the AC system is able to push dry air to every part of the conditioned space of your house. Now, the interesting thing about whole home dehumidification is if you have a crawl space, for example, whole home dehumidification does not, in most cases, cause the crawl space to dry out because the dry air is inside the ductwork and cannot reach the crawl space. So unless your ducts are super leaky, whole home dehumidifiers will not dry the crawl space. But guess what? You can set up a whole home dehumidifier with ventilation. So in other words, you're bringing outside air directly into the dehumidifier. That dehumidifier can be ducted to dry the crawl space while also ducted into the HVAC system in order to dry the whole home as well as the crawl space. My only caution on that is make sure you choose a beefy enough dehumidifier to ensure that you're covering the amount of moisture and space for the dehumidifier. So you may be wondering, why do I even keep talking about whole home dehumidification? Because that is the little extra power that you could use versus an ERV or an HRV if you are in a part of the country that has high humidity. Okay, an ERV does not necessarily lower humidity. It does a little bit, but it also can raise humidity if necessary versus a dehumidifier. So if you've got 90% humidity outside, an ERV will not be able to remove that humidity, where you could set up a model 1800 series or the 1820, 1830, or 1850 dehumidifier to bring in fresh air, lower the humidity, and then duct that fresh air into the HVAC system in order to ventilate the house. One other tip when setting up a whole home dehumidifier this way is I would almost always recommend going with the 1850. The reason why I like the April Air 1850 in this instance is you're pulling in sometimes 80, 90% relative humidity, and the 1850 is a more powerful, more pint per day dehumidifier in order to address all that high humidity. Plus, if you're thinking about using it in the crawl space and the whole home, you certainly want a dehumidifier that is stronger, more powerful, and able to handle a larger part of your home. Okay, so I hope you found that information helpful, and if you did, please like the video down below and let me know in the comments, are you using an ERV, HRV, or whole home dehumidifier to ventilate your home? Oh, and one last thing. Don't forget to register for that free April Air Dehu. I'm gonna put a link to that video down below so you and your family could potentially win a free April Air 1820 dehumidifier. Okay, so now for what I promised at the beginning of the video, what is the most important thing I feel to tackle as far as improving your indoor air quality? It's an easy thing to do and really important. You wanna make sure you get a very good furnace filter, okay? Like the AirSafe 2000 furnace filter. What makes it different is that it keeps air from going around the filter. If you're using a cardboard frame filter or a hard frame filter, air is gonna take the path of least resistance, right? So if the filter is getting clogged, then more and more air is going to start going around the filter and causing your ductwork to get dirtier and dirtier and dirtier. Therefore, you are the filter, Okay, so if you wanna check out the AirSafe 2000 filter, I'm gonna put a link down there below, but here's something else I'm gonna do. The first 25 people that comment down below, whether you're using an ERV, HRV, or a dehumidifier, or maybe you're not using anything at all. The first 25 people that comment down below, I'm going to give you a free AirSafe 2000 starter pack, which is a frame and filter. It's about a $20 value, so make sure you comment down below. Let us know what you're using. My name is Michael Church with Crawl Space Ninja. We hope you make it a happy and blessed day, and we'll see you later.